Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. My name is Nate Carpenter, and today we're going to be looking at building a Bootstrap tour inside Scriptcase. So Bootstrap tour, as it says here, is a way to show people how to use your website. So if we click Start Demo here, it's going to take me through the website. So I pop up an informational dialog here. I can go to Next, or I can end the tour. If I click Next, it's going to highlight another area of the website and provide some information on what that area it does. I can go back and forth between the steps, so I can go back to previous year, click Next, and then I can end the tour at any time. So we're going to be looking at how to integrate this into a grid application. So if you look down here, it has some how-to. It's pretty simple. First, you need to add the dependencies, as you would expect. It uses the Bootstrap library, so we're going to include that stuff, and then the Bootstrap tour library as well, which is custom for this application. Once those dependencies are added, then we can add just a basic version of that to our website. So we add all the dependencies, and then down here we can set up the tour. So we instantiate a tour object, and then we define the steps for that tour. So those are all the different areas that we're going to highlight. And there's documentation down here that we're going to look at that provide us lots of customization options. Then we choose the element that we're going to highlight by the ID. We put a title there, which is that title area. If I go up here and click it again, the Welcome to Bootstrap Tour. That's that title area. And then the content actually goes in the body of that dialog box right there. And then this whole dialog box is controlled by a template, which we're seeing in our documentation. And so you can add as many steps as you want. And once they're all added, then you can initialize the tour right there. And then you can start the tour right down here at the bottom. And that actually starts the tour. Let's go ahead and look at the documentation to see some of the options we have. So here are all the global options and the default values. So I'm going to show you this template section. So this is the default template for that dialog box that pops up, and we can pass it a different one, which is just some HTML. And down here are all the different options with some explanations of what they do, just like you would see in any documentation. Here's the template option. Again, there's a default template there on the right, and a definition of what some of the elements need to have. So the data role and all that. And as you scroll through these, you see a lot of different options. And here are the step options and all their default values. And one of the options we're going to use is this backdrop area. That's going to put a dark backdrop on there, and we can pass that through in the steps. So there's all that. And then we can click the download link, which is going to take us to the GitHub page where we can actually download this library. Now, I've already got it downloaded and set up in Scriptcase, so let's go over there and see how that's set up. So here we are in the Scriptcase development environment, and let's go to the external library where I set this up. So to go to Tools, External Libraries, and here are all my external libraries. I'm going to scroll down and find the one. Here it is right down at the bottom in the project area, Bootstrap Tour is what I've named that. So that's just the external library that I've created, and then I've imported all those files right there. So those are the four files that we need that we saw in the dependencies. And then we can reference this external library in our application. So let's go back and let's create a grid application to put this in. So going to click New Application. This is in the Samples project. Click Grid. So we're going to use the Samples database, and we're going to use the Sales table in there. You can do this with any table. I'm just using it for this one for example purposes. And let's name this correctly. I'm going to do Grid Sales Tour, like so. There's your SQL if you want to edit it. We're not going to worry about that. We can click Create now. All right, so our application is created. Let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like on the initial mode. Okay, so here it is. It's pretty much set up, but it's taking up the entire screen, and we don't really want it to do that. That's not going to work too well for our tour. So we're going to have it take up just part of the screen and center it. So we're going to click the grid module here, and the table width is going to be 50%. So I set it to 50, and the width unit is percent. Let's run that. And this will prevent any of the dialog boxes for our tour from running off the edge of the screen. It'll keep it nice and in the viewport of the user. There we go. So that'll make everything look a little bit more clean and user-friendly. So now we can get started with adding this into our grid, adding the tour into our grid. So our external library setup, we need to go to events in the onScript init event. So this is as the page is still loading. And first we need to add the R dependencies. So we're closing the PHP block up here because this is HTML. And then we're putting the link in for our style sheets, the Bootstrap and the Bootstrap Tour. So we're using the SC URL library macro, which is going to point to this library right here. So it's in the project, and then it's the Bootstrap Tour library is what we named it. So we tell it which library and then the file we are going to add. So we do that for the style sheets, and then the exact same thing for the JavaScript files as well. Now that that is done, we can close up our PHP block again, or open our PHP block again, so that we're ready to go. Let's save that. And now let's get started with adding our tour in. So the first thing we need to do is open up a new script area in our HTML document so we can put some more JavaScript in. So let me put the script tags in there. And now we need to do a document ready function. So this is the jQuery document ready function, which is going to load when the document is ready and everything. So let me put that in and let me close that area up. So this is where we're going to put all of our code for our tour, so it's executed at the correct time. Okay, so that's all in place. And now we can set up our template. So that's the first area that's going to define our dialog box and what that looks like. So if you click on this, that's where that template is going to do. So it's going to control those buttons and all that. So I'm going to put some HTML in, just like we saw in the documentation. It's just some HTML with the correct data role options. So we have a variable buttons, which is going to have some divs in it for some arrows and some different information that it needs. You can explore the documentation further if you want to see how this works more. We define the data role like previous, and then define the title of the button as back with those arrows. Do the same for next. And then the finish button is going to be a data role of end with a text of finish. And we close up all those divs, and that is set up and ready to go. So we'll pass through those buttons in the steps that we're going to set up. Now we need to define where we're going to put this. So the first element on our tour is going to be our quick search. So we need to get that element ID right there. So to do this, we can view the source of this or inspect it using our develop tools in Chrome is what I'm using. Okay, so there is our ID of the search box right there. So we can use that ID in our step. So first we need to set up our tour. We're going to instantiate our tour object right there. So let me copy that code and put it into our code here. Bring it over and then close up that area with the correct parentheticals and curly braces. Just like so. And then we need to start our steps area of this tour. So to do that, we can go back to our documentation and pull that example out right there. Just copy that little bit of code and paste it right here. Bring it over so it looks nice, and then close up our steps area as well with another square bracket. Make sure I get the right square bracket. There we go. Okay, so now we can define our first step. So I've got some code I'm going to copy in here since I've already got it written, but it's just like we saw in the example with one other option added. So let me copy that in here. And here we go. So we've got the curly braces, we've got the correct ID for a quick search, that's right there, that's where we got that. We've got the title, quick search, the content of it, right there, so it tells us what it does. And then we've got the placement, so it's going to move it over to the left, and then the template it uses is going to be our buttons, which is that variable right there. And then we are going to put a backdrop on, so it's going to black out the rest of the screen to kind of focus on the area that we're telling about. So that's our first step all set up and ready to use. Now we need to define the other steps. So we're going to go to the export option and we're going to provide that as an element of the tour. So there's that ID right there. And then we're going to do the same for the advanced search. So we need to find that ID. And there it is right there if we look in the HTML. And then this big grid area right here, we're also going to put as a step in our tour. So find that, SE grid body is that ID right there. So now we've got all of our IDs, and I'm going to copy in the code that uses those IDs to set up those steps. So let me copy that in, and it's going to be pretty much just like the first step we did, except we're swapping out the IDs now so it knows which element on the screen to use. So as you can see, I've set up all those three other steps now for the export, for the advanced search, and for the grid body down here at the bottom. So you can do this for any element on the screen. You just need to figure out the ID for it, that Scriptcase gives it, and then you're ready to go. So let's go ahead and save that. We've got our steps set up. Now we need to set up a button to control our tour width. So if we go back to the documentation here, it had this button right here, and we're going to set up a similar button so that we can start the tour or restart the tour whenever we want. So to do that, we need to add a button on our grid, and this can be any type of button. We're not going to add any code in there. We'll control it with our Bootstrap tour code. So we go to buttons, new button, name it tour. It can be any type. We're not worried about that. We're just going to make it a JavaScript button. Make sure it's named correctly because we're going to need that ID. And then I'm going to change the style here. This isn't necessary, but this is one of the styles we have set up here. We can give it a font awesome icon if we want, but I'm just going to change the label and leave it as is. We're not going to worry about any JavaScript code. We're going to set that up in the onScript init so that we know what to do with that button on an onClick. So that's all saved, and we just need to get the ID of that button. Simply run it here, and we can figure out which ID Scriptcase gave it. So there's our new button right there on the screen. Let me now click this and see if I can find the ID of it. And there it is, SC Tour Top. So now we can add that as another element in our tour, actually, so we can explain what that button does. This isn't necessary, but this is kind of helpful. So let me add just one little bit of code here, title, reset tour, clear and start tour over, placement, and we're not going to put a backdrop on it. So template of buttons again. So now we just need to initialize our tour and start it right here. So that's these two lines of code right here. And we still haven't captured the onClick of that button either yet. So we'll do that just after this. So copy that code and let me get it formatted correctly, tab it over so it looks nice. There we go. Now we just need to control when this button is clicked. So we're going to capture that onClick event and tell it to start the tour over. So here we have a little bit of code. It's going to get the onClick of that SC Tour Top button and tell the tour to restart. So that's in the documentation, that macro, that function there to restart the tour over if it's already started or it's just started again. So at this point, it should run. So let's go ahead and run our code. And there we go, it's all loaded. Let's click our tour button. And now we're touring our application. So there's a quick search. And it's putting a backdrop on the back. As you can see, it's blacking it out, our export. And our advanced search is not putting that backdrop on. And the reason is because we told the backdrop to be false for that one. So that one does not have a backdrop. So you can switch those on and off as it suits your purposes. And then advanced search and then the grid area is going to highlight that whole area right there and backdrop the rest. So I click next and there's our tour button, the last step in our tour. So the next button is grayed out and we can end the tour. And then we can restart it again if we wanted to see it again and then finish it at any point like we could in the other one. So that's how you build a basic Bootstrap tour in Scriptcase. So I hope this is helpful for you. This is really useful if you want to provide another way, a very user-friendly way to show users how to use your website. So I hope you can use this in your own development, and I'll see you in the next tutorials.